Learn AWS. Bye. Okay, I was just kidding. Let's roll the intro.
Hello, Internet. Welcome back to my another video. If you are new here, I am Revanth and I am working as a cloud architect. And in this channel, I am creating content related to cloud technologies and DevOps skills, some career guidance, and also current latest tech trends that's happening around the world. So consider subscribing if you are of that interest. If you are watching this video, I'm sure that you are a fresher who is considering a cloud or DevOps role, or you may be an experienced professional who is working on a different technology but would like to move to the cloud engineering or cloud architect space. Otherwise, you are already working as a cloud engineer but you want to upgrade your skill set. So I think you'll be fall onto any of these buckets. So do let me know on comment section which category you belongs to. Now let's jump into the actual discussion on which cloud platform to learn, AWS or Azure or GCP. There are n number of cloud vendors, for example AWS, Azure, GCP, Oracle, SAP, Huawei Cloud, Alibaba Cloud. There are new players that are coming into the space every day. So we are not going to talk about all of this, but we are going to pick the top three, AWS, Azure, and GCP. And I'm going to tell you like which cloud platform you can learn based on certain conditions and certain scenarios. So watch the video fully so that you will get an idea on which platform you can start learning and how to step up as a cloud engineer or cloud architect. When we talk about the cloud popularity, AWS is being used by 40% of the cloud users, whereas Azure is being used by 28% of the global users, and GCP is holding around 10 to 12% of global cloud users. So what this means to a cloud engineer or anyone who is considering a cloud profile, so that is where the number of jobs comes in. So since the AWS is being used by like 40% of the users, so the number of jobs which is requiring a AWS skill set will be far more higher compared to Azure or GCP cloud engineer. So the second place will go to Azure and third place will be for the GCP. This is just a high level of splitting the categories based on the cloud popularity, but we need to take other factors into the consideration. Now let's talk about the scenarios for each different buckets and let's discuss on which cloud platform they can pick up. If you are already working in a company and they are trying to adopt cloud, or else like they are migrating from their on-premise data center to cloud, then it is good that if you can pick up what are the cloud technology the company moves to. For example, if they are moving to OCI, Oracle Cloud Infra, it is fine that you can learn OCI, because you are not going to spend an extra hours learning that, but your company will be taking care of this certification, upskilling you into the cloud space. So it's going to be taken care by the company. So it's a wise choice to go by whatever cloud vendor or the provider that your company picks in. So the category number two is for the freshers. If you ask me, I would suggest you to start with AWS, because the number of jobs is usually higher. Also, the documentation provided by AWS for any of the services is far more easy to understand, and you can find more number of tutorials out there in the YouTube or Udemy or any course platforms, which means you can learn AWS much more easy and faster compared to the other cloud vendors. Another good reason to pick up AWS is the companies, whoever is hiring for Azure or GCP, they usually hire the person who has the knowledge of AWS or who has done some certification and have some good exposure on AWS. They hire that person to manage their Azure or GCP cloud, because so most of the cloud platform is of the same technologies, but rather they have a different names. So it's easy for the one who already has a good understanding on any of these cloud platform to manage the other cloud platform. So they usually hire the one who has good experience on AWS, but they put the engineers to work on the other platform so that they can easily pick up and they can find good experience resources as well. Category number three, if you are working on some Windows based administration role, or if you are currently managing the MS Office and Office 365, these kind of licenses, and Azure AD and .NET, if you extensively work on .NET based workflows in your company, then you can consider Azure. So what are the tools that we already discussed is being managed or owned by Microsoft, so they have a very good fit in within the Azure cloud. If you have these experiences which I previously mentioned, then you can consider Azure so that you can easily learn that, and also you have very good exposure to all these tools earlier, so it will be very easy for you to get this transition to cloud. Category number four, the people who would like to move from a different technology or domain to the cloud engineering space. I think most of the people who are watching this video is going to fall on this category. That is what I believe. So comment which category you belong to. If you fall into this category, so my suggestion for you is to pick up GCP, because you already have some knowledge on your different technology, which means like you can be from software development background or on-premises DevOps background. When you come from this background, and pick up AWS, you are going to see a huge supply for AWS, because the freshers are going to pick up AWS, and also there are n number of certified AWS people and n number of experienced AWS people who is already available in the market. You'll be facing huge supply for AWS. But as of now, there is a good demand for the GCP professional, where the companies are looking for experienced and certified GCP professionals. So this is my suggestion. If you are already working on a different technology, but you would like to move to the cloud engineering space, but you want to pick up the one with less competition, then I would suggest you to pick up GCP. As of now, it is growing in a rapid speed, overcoming the growth speed of AWS and Azure. So there will be huge demand for GCP professionals. So this is my suggestion. Hold on. There is one other category where you are already working as a cloud engineer or cloud architect for a different cloud vendor. It can be AWS or Azure or GCP. So you would be wondering which cloud platform to pick up next to become a multi-cloud architect. If you already learned AWS and GCP, I would suggest you to pick up Azure as well. So you will become a saturated, fully multi-cloud engineer. The reason why I have put GCP in the second place and Azure in the third place is by considering Azure's back-to-back downtimes and poor documentation and the number of services that they offer. I strongly believe that GCP can easily beat over the competition of Azure and take over the second position and push the Azure to third position. And also to mention that it's not going to happen anytime sooner, but it will take a decade. But for sure, I believe that GCP will become the second most dominant cloud vendor and Azure is going to be the number three, if I'm not wrong. So let's see what happens in the cloud space. Another reason why I'm putting GCP first in many of the places is considering the area of business. For example, if you are a retail company or e-commerce company, definitely I'm sure that you will stay away from AWS because they are already into the e-commerce market. There is a kind of insecurity considering the data. AWS may take over the data, overlook the data, their business reason. I know there are like security policies and all exist, but there is kind of insecurity among the companies who work on these retail and e-commerce business. So definitely they will stay away from AWS. So obviously they are going to land the data into Azure or GCP. And the next thing comes in where they need to work on the A and ML stuff. So you know who is best in the AI and ML products across these cloud vendors? It's GCP guys. So most companies is going to prefer GCP compared to Azure. So it's going to be stronger and stronger. So if I have to suggest one cloud vendor or cloud provider to learn that's common for all of these categories, then definitely it's going to be the GCP. So start with GCP, do a foundational course, and then see which branch interests you, like a system ops or developer or DevOps engineer, whichever career path is more interest to you within the GCP cloud domain, pick up that, do certification, get land into your dream job and secure a highly good package. And I wish you all the best for that. So see you in the next video. Until then, signing off, your Raymond, your cloud architect. See you.